Hey, Jaina. Good to see you. Hello, Dark Lord. Hello, hello. Happy Sunday. Hello, Mermaid. Hello, Colleen. Thank you. I am well. Thank you for asking. I think today we're working with the sacral and the root, kind of closing out the last week or so of work we've been doing here. Hello, Rook Butterfly. Good evening. Happy to see everyone. Hello, happy Sunday, lady. Hello, Jill. Good to see you. Thank you. Hello, Abby. I'm glad you're here. How was everybody's weekend? Thank you. I was away all weekend, so I showered and did my hair elsewhere with other stuff, so it's been a little off. Hello, Daddy. Yeah, it was really busy for me too. I am pooped and went by too fast. I feel like every weekend is. Hello. Oh, this sounds so fun. Hey, Pammy. I hope you had a good trip. I don't know that I've seen you since you've been back, but hello, Brianna. Hello, Mexico. Hey, Kelly. No problem. Just relax. We'll take care of you. Oh, at least you're planning a vacation, so that's good. Hi, Zia. Happy Sunday. Okay, make sure. I'm gonna start with smoke today. Hello, Kit Kat. Hello, Aries guy. I'm glad to hear that. Hello, Jen. I feel like you're early. So just bringing a little smoke to start cleansing us out. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Hello. Thank you. So today we're going to work with the sacral and the root, kind of finishing out what we've been doing the last week or so. Hello, South Carolina. Oh, I hope you get good results from your doctor. Virginia. Happy Monday to you on the edge of the world. It's kind of cool that you guys get to like be the first to greet a day. Let me get something to practice with. Thank you. Hello. Thank you. Hello. You can find the music from this live on my playlist on my YouTube channel. So just click into my bio. There's a link for my YouTube. And there's a playlist. And this is the last song on the playlist. How lovely. Hello, Morocco. Hello, Pennsylvania. Hello, Minnesota. I love that. Thank you. I'm glad you're here. Hello, Philippines. Hello, San Francisco. Thank you. I appreciate that. Hello, permaculture. Oh, that's amazing. I didn't know they had a piece there. Now I want to go. Hello, Brazil. Thank you. I don't think I've been to the Smithsonian since I was like 17. I had green hair then. Oh, that's awesome. Most of the lights I got from Amazon, pretty inexpensive, $10 or $15. Send in healing to your kitty. Thank you. Hello. Thank you. It's like a little viva piñata. Our intention is the sacral and the root chakra finishing out. Kind of, we have an eclipse on Tuesday, so trying to get ourselves in order before then. Thank you. To be fair, TikTok does do that on purpose. They usually put somebody's video with their live. But you maybe should stay if it feels right. I think it's just a partial eclipse, but I'm not 100%. So you want to pay attention to where Scorpio may be in your chart, which house it is in, and that may be where this is hitting you. But in general, just be patient because things can get a little shifted, a little strange. Thank you. You are not that late. I'm still just bringing some smoke in. Okay. Let me find a safe place to put that. So I'm going to start off with the root, the sacral, and we're going to work with this is Sedona Jasper from Sedona, Arizona. It has this really warm, comforting vibration to it. And just starting to work with our sacral a little bit, opening up some flow, opening ourselves up to our creativity and passions, and unblocking any of the things going on there. It does look like a little peach or a little pumpkin. It was actually, I had made an order from a company that was in Sedona Jasper and they sent this with it. A munchkin. Thank you so much. I don't know who that is actually. I should definitely check them out. I love ASMR. Like certain kinds. There's actually kinds I don't like, but for the most part, I love ASMR. No, probably because I'm usually kind of in bed at 10:30. Like, I am a sleepy lady. I take care of my bedtime schedule, so usually no phone at that point. I usually watch ASMR or Reiki videos in the afternoons when I'm working. Kind of gets me through that last bit of the day really nicely. Also, I feel like at 40, I have to be careful, take care of my body, make sure I get all that sleep. I absolutely agree. There's some ASMR that just makes me, I'm like, nope, that's not for me. And then some I really like. Oh, I'm so glad. Lovely. Oh, so cute. Hello, Sarah. I find a lot of information in different books. There's so many. Just find one that's interesting to you. Though usually for chakras and crystals, you're going to need several. And most bookstores, Amazon, those places will have some. And then over time, just working with them is helpful in feeling the energy. Or your library. Fantastic idea. Your local library. That's really good, actually. Sometimes you feel like I read the information in a book and never again. And then some I reference, so it's hard to know at first. I do have a YouTube. If you click into my bio, you can find a link there, or just search the same name. There's a lot of Reiki classes. I have some available in my Patreon if you want to learn Reiki, but basically just going through classes and then practicing and using that helps quite a bit. That's interesting. Oh, I'm so glad. I will take it. Hello, welcome. Thank you. So once somebody becomes a master, they learn how to attune others. So a master is going to give you your Reiki attunements and teach you. Sedona Jasper, but very much could see orange calcite there. And this is just a jasper that came from Sedona. Feels kind of like warm, positive, comforting. A donut hole, a munchkin. Thank you, I appreciate it. Thank you. Always a food reference. Oh, thank you. I choose the... It sometimes pops up the little, like, live goal thing. I think it changed it to, like, Halloween gifts, so it popped it up. But yes, I have 20 cauldrons as our live goal, I guess. So you can do whatever feels best to you. Some people just close their eyes, or sometimes people will do other things and just let that. Yes, Jen, yes. Or sometimes people just let it wash over them and do other stuff. So whatever feels best to you. Thank you. Uh-oh, Meredith's about to do an ad. Sorry. The music, like, restarted or something. So that was a little piece of Sedona Jasper, kind of small little soft piece, but it feels really warming and sort of lighter, comforting, working with the sacral, starting to kind of warm ourselves up a little bit. And your reminder to take a sip of water. Good evening, Doris. So I'm gonna work with this piece of garnet, and it's all kind of dinged up. I love this piece. I think it's almondine. I always say that wrong. Garnet is for the particular shape that it's in. But this one feels a little bit stronger, a little bit warmer, feels maybe a little bit more visceral. Working with the sacral, and this one kind of really empowering it a little more. They are. This one is the High Priestess, and this one is the Star. Kind of my two favorite cards. Yeah, so this one, again, was actually another free crystal that I got when I ordered something else. But it is so dinged up, and I love it for that. Yes, still in the sacral, and then we'll switch to the root. I worry about that. I just lost internet. Did I lose internet? I will say that I am worried about my internet connection. So, just a fair warning. Okay. I am located in Vermont, and I do sessions over Zoom, and there's a link in my bio. I'm glad. I haven't been here all weekend, so I don't know what the state of our internet is. Thank you, I appreciate it. The meatball. Oh, interesting. I don't think you really want me humming. I'm not the best solo music person. I can sing along in the car, but alone, it's no good. Maybe there's some sort of worldwide internet hiccups. Thank you, I appreciate it. It's definitely one of my favorite colors. I really just like a lot of colors, like purple and blue and green and pink. Like, I like having more than one color. It's probably my favorite. So I hope it helps. I do like reds and orange. I do notice it will sometimes mess with the camera a little bit. Like, TikTok doesn't know how to deal with the orange. It just turns it into like a weird sun. Yeah, purples and pinks are probably some of my favorites. So it looks black, but it is really a dark red. And you can kind of see the spots where it's gotten dinged up, and it's garnet. So on here, it looks pretty black, but in person, it's a deep, deep red. It feels quite strong and powerful. Gives a bit more strength to our personal selves. I will say there's nothing that tells you that tapping does anything. You have to just kind of tap to have known that. So it's interesting. You're not the only one, believe me. Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, interesting. Yeah, and don't worry about tapping yourself out. We want you to definitely stay. I hope you had some nice dinner. Yeah, they added a bunch of Halloween themed gifts, which I think they should have added like a week ago. Like, Halloween for me feels like the whole month of October. They know how to get you eventually. The gifts are like a tip jar, so eventually it gets turned back into money for the creator. TikTok definitely takes their cut. But they help support creators. They're also very interactive, so I think that TikTok values that a bit for creators. I don't know how much. So it helps. Thank you. Oh, goodness, 82. That's cute. It's a snoring kitty. Thank you. I appreciate it. So that was some garnets bringing in for our sacral, just kind of a little more empowering, a little stronger, a little more courageous. And then we're going to move on to the root. And a reminder to have some water. So next up, I have this Mookate Jasper Point. And this one feels really earthy, really supportive and healing. A good one for physical pain and emotional healing. Just a really nice and supportive stone. So bringing in some strength and support up through our root and really kind of connecting and flowing energy throughout the body. Oh, it does look like strawberry cheesecake. And Mookate Jasper comes in lovely purples and browns and golds. And as far as I know, I think it is only found in Australia. But very beautiful. Raspberry cheesecake, I can see that. It's probably like a berry cheesecake because it looks like there's some blackberry in there too. Oh, that's awesome. I love fluorite. Thank you, I appreciate it. Oh my god, that's adorable too. Steak with cheesecake. That would be so good. Thank you. Thank you. I feel like for points, they add a little bit more directed energy, at least personally for me. So when I'm working on someone or videos, I actually like points a lot. And even I will use them on myself by drawing them like on myself. I find that they concentrate it a little bit more that way. But before I did a lot of Reiki work with people, I really didn't use towers as much. Sounds like the best of everything. Oh, good point, Brianna. Having them point away from you when you're trying to release something or pull something out. do a little plucking on this one. Thank you, I appreciate it. Hello. Thank you. I'm so glad. Thank you. And I find that the stone is really helpful for grounding and healing, both emotionally and physically. Thank you. So it's a good stone for when you're feeling a little bit low, especially if you're not feeling well, like feeling sick, or you're feeling down in your energy. It feels like it sort of grounds and supports and heals. There's a lot of vitality and grounding in it. Leucite jasper. Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry. Hopefully this helps you feel a little better. So for Reiki, you take classes. There's attunements and classes. They're pretty easy to find either locally or online, and I have some available in my Patreon. Reiki 1, 2, and Master level are up already. Thank you. Hello, Brazil. Thank you. On occasion, I definitely feel like I need to cleanse myself after clients. A lot of times with clients, it's less about the energy work and more about the discussion. You're usually, if they're really having a rough time, you're talking back and forth, you're feeling empathetic towards them, and just any other place where you're dealing with humans and strong emotions, it can kind of linger with you. So you're going to give yourself some space. to be able to ground out and release that energy so you're not thinking about it after the session. So it definitely feels like less when I'm digging around in their energy and more just because you're speaking with them and, you know, kind of in it with them. Thank you, I appreciate that. Hopefully you're not driving, Lisa. It depends on the day and how I'm feeling, but a lot of times I usually, after I'm done with heavy sessions, I spend a few minutes and sit down on my meditation cushion and just kind of breathe through things. Some days it's as simple as just doing a meditation where I'm paying attention to things, like some birds outside. Sometimes eating is really helpful for me because it's putting us back in our bodies and less in our heads. A lot of times when it's especially heavy chatting back and forth, you can continue to have those conversations in your head. And so getting yourself back into your body and grounding your energy down is helpful. Thank you, I appreciate it. I would say that I'm not as good at working with energy when I'm talking, and during private sessions I don't talk, but for these, I feel like that's, I don't know, part of it. But no, I don't feel it's personally as good. It's like doing anything and talking, you're just a little bit distracted. So this is Mookite Jasper, and you can see the kind of different reds and purples with it. Sometimes they're golden yellows and oranges, and a lot of times these nice deserty sand colors. One of my favorite stones. It feels very healing for the body and for the soul. It feels like it has a lot of vitality and longevity. Oops, I grabbed the wrong stone, sorry. And then I was gonna bring in some black obsidian. This feels really grounding and cleansing and protective at the same time. Thank you, I appreciate it. We only have one more to go. And definitely, yes, hydrate when we switch stones. I should do that as well. So bringing in black obsidian, kind of cleanse out anything we've missed and giving us a little bit of a protective layer. The week ahead might be a little rough for some people with an eclipse. It might be really good. It depends. They're a bit of a wild card, and how it hits you depends. So protecting ourselves where we can. Grounding out excess energy where we can is very helpful. Yeah, everyone has kind of a different preference on videos, whether I'm talking or not. And so I try to add a mix so that, thank you, I appreciate it. Thank you guys all for your cauldrons, I appreciate it. I believe it's on Tuesday, then it's a new moon. And eclipse in Scorpio, and then there'll be another in 2 weeks on the full moon. I think that's a partial, but eclipses happen twice a year, so they're not like something crazy and out of control. They're just a little bit of a shift each year, kind of a little portal of shifting from one to the next. I am not a Pisces, no. Thank you. I appreciate it. For me personally, I'm not usually doing too much with the eclipse. I'm not super active with it. I'm just kind of being reflective, seeing what shows up, what things need to shift or change. Thank you. So this is black obsidian that's been polished into a kind of a palm stone shape. And black obsidian is really good for kind of cleansing and clearing and grounding and protecting. Thank you. I liked onyx. Actually, I don't think I have any. I used to, but I feel like I lost that piece. Thank you, I appreciate it. Thank you. No, it's just me. I do my own hair, so it happened to turn out good today. It's doing kind of a weird thing, which is working. This is black obsidian, which is pretty easy to find stone and really nice and protective. A good grounding stone. I'm glad you made it. was worried it was gonna stop. Hello, Scotland. Yeah, I think we need some protective vibes for the week. Oh, I definitely think you guys can hit. After what I saw you guys do the other day, I definitely think you can hit 200K. Thank you, I appreciate it. And Reiki is a really nice thing because you can use it on yourself. So I learned Reiki a while back and I used it on myself for quite a while. It was very helpful in my healing journey. I love the enthusiasm, but that's a lot to do in 10 minutes or 8 minutes. So that was black obsidian, a very nice stone for protection and grounding. Can feel like it sort of, that grounding feels like it cleanses out the body of energy, unwanted energy. So we're going to bring out some rhodochrosite or ham. This is a stone that I love for the heart space, feels very healing and forgiving and good for self-love and courage. And I like to use this stone at the end of these sessions just in case we've kind of unearthed anything that's feeling too much. We're kind of healing and smoothing that over so we can kind of deal with whatever has been brought up during the session. And officially ham light to anybody coming in after this. And I'm going to do some plucking with this one because it's nice and it feels like once we pull something away, we sort of replace it with a little self-love. Hello, Buenos Aires. I think you'll do just wonderful. Thank you, Kelly. Oh, you guys did it. You did 200,000. Fantastic. That was so fast. I didn't even... But it's helping. Yes, ham a fan for the win. I've never had much luck with forcing myself to have lucid dreams. I've been trying that since I was a teenager. I've only had like 2 or 3. To become a Reiki practitioner, you take a Reiki 1 class and get attuned. There will be a Reiki master there that will tune you to Reiki and then teach you how to open the flow and a few other things in Reiki 1. And then you do that for a while and then you can have Reiki 2 and Reiki master. Thank you, it's really pretty. A lucid dream is when you're aware that you're dreaming. So you know, not that you remember your dream, but a lucid dream is in your dream, you're aware that it's a dream, and then you start to change things. So you can, you know, you're like, I want to fly, and then you just fly because you know it's a dream. To me, it has only happened a few times in my life. Some people are really good at it. And because you're in control and know that you're dreaming, you can do whatever you want. And control it. But I literally have been learning about that since I was like 17 and have never been able to really do it much more than once or twice. Probably three. I think I've had three.
But I do know that some people are very proficient and good at it. So there are ways to learn a little bit more. Oh, that's cool. You should see what you can do with those lucid dreams. I think 250 is a very reasonable and fantastic goal, so I appreciate it. The Hamlinator. You are officially Hamly. All hail to the Holy Ham. Wow. You guys are very, you're really doing it. You're very welcome. You guys are absolutely gonna do that. Wow. Look at that. I'm very impressed. I'm very impressed. I don't know how you did that so fast. That's crazy. And just on time still. We still have a few minutes. So thank you guys for all your support. So that is rhodochrosite. Gosh, my internet is so weird. Hopefully it continues. Rhodochrosite, which is so lovely for our heart space. Thank you guys to all of you for your finger taps, your answering questions, being supportive, the mods for keeping it nice and chill in here, and for you all for showing up for yourselves. You guys are amazing, and I appreciate you all so much. I have such a lovely community of you guys, and it's just really nice. So thank you guys so much for showing up every week, and I hope that you have a lovely week. Tuesday's going to be a little rough. I will be on Tuesday morning just doing a cleanse at 9 a.m. Eastern, so maybe join us if you're having a rough go of it, and enjoy your week. Thank you guys so much. Have a good night.